In today's tutorial, we are going to take a GIS practical interview question, and the question is on population projection. So I want to see how we can do population projection in Excel. Please remember to subscribe to this channel. Thank you. So this is the question, GIS practical question. The population census of localities in the year 2015 is given in table 1, and there has been no census since then. Given that the growth rate in these localities is 3%, project the population of the localities to the year 2025. So this is the population of the localities in year 2015, and they want us to project it to 2025. As we all know that data collection in GIS is one of the most expensive aspect of GIS. So the data was collected in year 2015, and instead of going to collect data again in 2025, they want us to project the population. So this is the question, and the solution is in form of population projection. So let's use Newman formula, and this is the formula we are going to use in Excel. PO is equals to PN plus P bracket open bracket PN multiplied by R close bracket N all over 100. So where PO is the population of the future date, which is 2025. PN is the base population of the year 2015. R is the growth rate, and N is the number of intermediary year between the base year and the future year. So to start with, let's copy this formula into Excel to help us, which I have done. This is the formula we are going to use. Then secondly, let's copy this table, the table which is the question. Let's copy it, copy, and go to Excel and paste it here. Yes, we have our question and we have our function here, or formula we are going to use. So what we want to do is population projection in Excel using Newman formula. So how do we do that? Let's go back to our Excel. So to do that, this PO is what we are looking for, which is future population of year 2025. Then to do that, come here and enter this formula. So the population of the future year, to project it according to this formula, the first thing we need to do is that we need to find the intermediary year. We are given that R, which is rate, is equal to 3. We have this is given in the question. Then N, which is intermediary year, it will be, we have it, the base year is 2015 and the future year is 2025. So now our N here, which is intermediary year, will be equal to 2025 minus 2015, so it's 10 years. So R is 3 years, I mean 3%, and N is 10 years. Now to now calculate our future population, we enter this formula, so which will be equal to the base year is this one plus open bracket, we open bracket here, open another bracket, PN, which is this, multiply by R, which is 3, close brackets, multiply by N, this N, which is 10. 10, then close brackets. All over 100 divided by 100. So enter. So this is the future population for 2025 for this very locality. So to calculate for all, since it is a formula, just drag and draw or just double click here. Yes, this is the future projection. Now let's highlight this and find the total population. Click on some. This is the total population of at 2015. Then this one also, auto sum. This is the future population. So we have done the projection. So what we can do, two more steps. So to answer the question, copy this. Copy. Go back to the question table. This is it, and paste it. Paste. So we have answered the question. So the 2015 population is this. By 2025, given the growth rate of 3%, this is what we are going to have. However, we need to verify that our calculation is correct. To do that, come back to Excel. Come back to Excel. In this Excel, we were given that the growth rate, we can verify any of the variable to make sure that what we did is correct. And the best way to do that is to, for example, let's verify the rates if it is correct. So let's look at the difference in total population. So difference is equals to the total population as at 2025 minus the total population as at 2015 is equals to this, the difference. Now we want to see percentage change. To see the percentage change, which is change, is equal to the difference divided by the base total multiplied by 100, enter, is 30% change between this 2015 and 2025. Now the intermediary year was given to be 10. So to the rate now we want to verify is equal to this 30% of total change divided by the intermediate year divided by this 10. Enter, is giving us 3. So we can see that we have gotten back the 3% rate of change. So which means this calculation is correct. So in essence, this is how to do population projection in Excel. So if you go back to the question, so the locality's population as of 2015 is this, and by 2025 this is the projected population using the Newman formula in Excel. I hope this video is helpful to someone. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.